By linking your stone's liberties together, you create connections of stones that share liberties. By connecting your stones, you make patterns on the board that both surround territory and protect your stones from capture. Here's an example. These three stones now share eight liberties together. It is more difficult for your opponent to surround these stones now than when they were alone on the board. You can continue to link more stones to these and spread out across the board, gaining territory. But keep in mind that if your opponent surrounds all these liberties, they get all of your stones, not just one.
No, making eyes doesn't mean distracting your opponent with goofy eye gestures. It's just another way of gaining territory and protecting your stones from capture should they become surrounded. Here's what we mean. In this example, Black has connected their stones together in such a way as to create two open liberties within the formation. Even if all these stones are surrounded by White, the Black stones can't be captured. This is because if White plays in one of these open spaces, or eyes, White will no longer have any liberties for that stone. While Black still has one liberty, White's stone will be immediately captured. This is called committing suicide in Go terms. Suicide of a single stone is not allowed. Having two eyes, or open liberties, Black's formation always has two liberties open and is safe from capture. This may seem confusing at first, but as you play, you'll understand it better.
But beware the single eye, because your opponent can capture all of your stones in this situation. This is because they can take your last liberty and all of your stones in the process. This might make you sad.
Go was introduced to Korea by Chinese government officials around 200 AD. It's believed that the game was introduced to the Japanese around 500 AD, where it gained its most widespread popularity. The rule of Ko sounds like an ominous video game overlord, but it's just another term thought up long ago to keep the game moving. Let me explain. A problem can arise while playing Go, where you and your opponent find yourself capturing each other's stones over and over again. Here's an example. In this case, you capture your opponent's stone with a move like this. Then they capture you back again. And then you capture them back again. This could go on forever. So the ancient guys and gals along the way decided on a rule called Ko, which states that you can't repeat the same series of captures on the Go board without first playing another move in between. This is designed to prevent what is called invariation. In other words, if you capture your opponent's stone, they can't recapture on the next move, but must play on another part of the board in order to keep the game moving. While you pondered this, we're going to give you some more facts and stuff. One bit of Go myth that may interest you is the story of a samurai, Lord of Tamba, who was a very accomplished swordsman and scholar. He was extremely fond of Go. He heard of a monk in the area who was very skillful in Go and invited him to his castle for a game. During the game, the monk began to make fun of his host playing, at which point the samurai cut off his head. The monk's ghost used to visit the castle, poke its head over the walls and say, "How about just one more game?"
At this point, we want to show you a quick game. You should watch this game and look for the points that we've shown you so far. Make sure to rewind and pause the tape as you need to. Here goes.
Once you believe that all the space on the board is defined, you complete the game by filling in the neutral points. Neutral points are empty spaces on the board that either black or white could take and gain more points. The rule of thumb on this should always be, if in doubt, play it out. In this game, black played last, so white can play on the upper left-hand corner and take one more point. Then it's black's turn to play on the highlighted point in that same corner. Now white takes the last neutral point in the lower right corner. In other words, if you think you can still play and capture more territory or stones of your opponent, then by all means you should keep playing. Remember, if in doubt, play it out. The game ends when both players agree that all territory on the board has been established. Space plus stones equals territory. One player may pass on their next move because they think that the game is over. If the other player agrees and passes as well, then you determine the life and death of the stones on the board. At this point, both players decide on which stones are prisoners. In this game, the only prisoner is the highlighted white stone in the upper part of the board. This stone is taken off and given back to white. If you have any prisoners, you give those back to your opponent as well.
If you both agree the game is over, you both pass again. Then start adding up territory. This is where you use what's called fill-in counting. You fill in your territory by taking the stones you have left in your bowl and filling in the empty spaces within your own territory. The player who can fill in all of their stones wins the game. In this game, black wins. That's me. Because black has filled in all of her remaining stones into her territory, while white still has four stones remaining in his bowl. And remember that each player gets the same amount of stones at the beginning of the game. And if you play on a 19 by 19 board, you can use the Ing measuring bowl shown here to quickly count your stones for you.
Well, that's about it for the basics of Go. Try playing it with your friends and see what happens. If you feel like you've missed anything, just rewind the tape and go over it again.
And if you can't find someone to play with, ask your teacher about local Go associations and clubs. And if you're really hooked by now, you can call American Ing Go at
415-641-1452
for more information.
We hope you enjoy the game, and if you really get into it, there are tournaments being organized as we speak, where you can play Go with other people and win trophies and prizes.
We'll include a list of resources you can contact to get more information on this exciting game. Enjoy!